Do you like it?
I do.
You do?
Absolutely. I've lived with it for 65 years.
Oh, that, 65 years? Yes. That's fantastic. Mm. I think it's absolutely miraculous. I adore it.
How nice.
This is the sort of archetypal Minton majolica ware. Mm. Majolica, as I've said so many times before, is an earthenware with these bright-coloured glazes, which were so popular in the second half of the 19th century. Minton was perhaps the best of all manufacturers, and they made this tea set. I think I've only ever seen one other complete one, and the last one, I think, was about 1973. So to see another one turn up here, I think, is so exciting. I love the way it's been designed. It's been very cleverly thought out. The teapot is made from a whole lot of nuts. The sucre is a squash or gourd. The milk jug, I think, is that not asparagus? What's it? Artichoke, yes. That's called, isn't it? Mm. Then we've got two teacups, and again, as gourds with leaves coming off. And the saucers are lily pads. Each piece is carefully, fully marked. We've got the Minton name impressed. Mm-hmm. We've got a potter's mark, a date code, and a mould number, which happens to be 1349 on here. And that was the mould for that shape, was that number. And in fact, on this one, we've got a whole range of dates from 1872 to 74. You don't know what your parents paid for it, do you?
Yes, £50.
£50? Mm. It was a lot of money, 65.
£50, I suppose, about 70 years ago.
That was a lot of money. So they clearly rated it as an important object.
Yes, yes.
Well, I think they were right to do so, because majolica has now really become a cult collecting field. The market's slightly flat at the moment, but it's certainly going to pick up again. There's no doubt about that. And conservatively, I would put about £2,500 to £3,500 on this.
Really?
Bit of a shock.
Staggered.
This is a piece which we bought on impulse. About 30 years ago, we were travelling to London for a weekend, and we stopped. We saw it in the window of an antique shop. When I asked the price, I realised that I couldn't possibly afford it.
How much was it?
35 guineas.
Well, and that's quite a lot of money, wasn't it?
It was. Yes. It was more than half my monthly salary at the time.
Right.
So we reluctantly said no thank you, went home. Following Monday morning, I phoned up the shop and said, please reserve it for me.
Well, we've looked at a good many of these coffers and chests over the years, but it's a shame not to look at a couple of points on this one, which just take it out of the ordinary. As you know, virtually every house in the land had at least one of these to put linen, or even the occasional lover, so they said. The one thing that, if you're going to buy one of these 17th century pieces, it is nice to have the original hinges.
Yes, yes.
And the old iron double hoop hinge, of which this is the top part, it's just the end of a split pin, has so often broken. And here you can see, well, you know, when I first looked at it, I think those are probably the best, thickest, and best preserved iron hinges I've ever seen.
I mean,
they are so good, so pure. Yeah. They could have been on there 50 years rather than since 1660, when this thing was made.
I suppose, I don't know.
Yes, absolutely. And I mean, that is marvellous to see. And the other thing is, certainly with these panel front ones, to get a bit of craftsmanship. And here you've got absolutely everything. The point about this is that so many of them were plain and done in the Victorian time, recarved, or carved up in the Victorian period. And the thing about 17th century carving, it might have been slightly primitive, but it was extremely well put together and well balanced.
Yes.
And it was precise. And everything on here you can see was done either with a ruler or with a compass. The drawings are either roundels or straight lines.
Yes, I see.
And they were created with the use of a half round chisel, a round punch, or simply a gouge. And those were his working tools. I think pound for pound, one was probably giving more 10 to 15 years ago for good coffers like this than we are now.
Yeah.
Nevertheless, having said that, last year's price for this would have been about £800. There was a definite slump. This year, you could expect to get £1,250 to £1,400 for it, quite hopefully.